Writing about life as it's lived. I saw that line related to this lady who joins us now on Coffee Country and Cody. Welcome, Carly Pearce, all over the world on WSM and Circle Television. And that's what you have done in spades and so successfully. I'm so proud of you. I just want to reach through here and get a hold of you.
Oh, I love you so much. You know that. You're my favorite.
And as we talk, this is the week of Loretta Lynn's 89th birthday. And in recent days, you have walked out on the Grand Ole Opry stage and done what in honor of your fellow Kentuckian?
Well, I never realized just how much I knew that Loretta and I were both from Kentucky. I also knew that my grandmother was a coal miner's daughter, but I had no idea until the last year and a half just how much I could relate to the way that she wrote music and how she was unapologetically herself. And so I wrote her a letter in the form of a song of kind of asking her all of these things of how she lived her life, and that I now understood why she sang the way she does, because now I get it a lot. And it's just so, she tweeted me, Bill.
Did she really?
She tweeted me. She had the blue check and she said, I love your song and we should get together and sing sometime. And I said, Loretta, you tell me where and I'll be there.
You were halfway. You were
I was halfway already there
by then, weren't you?
Honestly, I was already stalking her in the window. It's fine.
And that follows the emotion of those songs. We talk about writing life as it's lived, or as is often said in Nashville, write what you know. But that came on the heels of 29, which has been critically acclaimed and accepted universally.
Yeah, I feel like I just really dug in deep over quarantine and decided that fans have given me this gift of wanting me to speak my truth. And I decided to dig in deeper than I ever thought I could. And 29 came from the most vulnerable place in my life and the most vulnerable time of my life. And I feel like maybe 29's not done. So we'll see.
That tribute to Loretta, how long did that take to write that song? And when did you write it and then decide, hey, I'm going to do this on the Opry for the very first time?
I wrote it last summer and it took about 30 minutes to write. It was very quick. And I feel like, you know, my producer Busby passed away from cancer and I went through this whole journey of trying to find myself again. And when I wrote that song, I was like, man, this is so country. I don't know that I may have just written this for myself, but now I decided to debut it after 29 has come out after I have found this true, sound that I didn't even know I could make relevant to today's mm-hmm. country. Mm-hmm. And now it feels like it is a part of 29. Like it feels like it's going to have its time. And that's just so awesome to me that I'm getting to make the music that I always wanted to make.
Well, you know, the new thing is deluxe edition. Luke Bryan's done it. Luke Combs has done it. Why shouldn't you? Female of the Year nominee, single and music event of the year with I Hope You're Happy Now, 3 Academy of Country Music Awards for Carly Pearce. And guess who joined us a little while ago and said, look, I said, who's your best girlfriend in the group in which you are nominated? And Kelsey Ballerini said, oh, Carly.
I love Kelsey. She's been somebody that has always had my back. She had my back when I didn't have a record deal. I was her opening act. She didn't have to take me out there. I was just a girl that had a dream and she knew it and she believed in it and let me ride her tour bus and didn't want me to drive my 12 passenger van through the night because she wanted me to get a good night's sleep. So that's the kind of heart that Kelsey has. And I love her.
And the dream continues to come true in the most extraordinary ways for Carly Pearce. I love you dearly. Thank you for joining us on Coffee Country and Cody.
Love you. Good to see you.
You too, baby.